Excellency Dr. Unity Dow, Minister of Education and Skills Development of Botswana, Your Excellency, you have the floor.
Mr. President of the General Conference, Mr. Chairperson of the Executive Board, Madam Director of UNESCO, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I bring you greetings from the government and the people of the Republic of Botswana. I'm deeply honored to address this distinguished assembly on the 38th session of UNESCO, of the UNESCO General Conference. But before I do so, Mr. President, let me join others in congratulating you to your election to the presidency. I am convinced that with your leadership, with the leadership, you know, for the various persons who are at the helm of the various structures of UNESCO, together we can bring this body to even greater heights. Mr. President, allow me to share with you a few of the achievements from my own country, Botswana. Botswana continues to allocate over 20% of its annual national budget to education, and indications are that this will continue to be so. Botswana further continues to review its policies in alignment to international trends and in response to national priorities. And one such example is the adoption recently of what we call ETSSP, or the Education and Training Sector Strategic Plan. This plan or strategy is underpinned by, among others, a focus of lifelong learning, developing new alternative pathways for education, strengthening skills development, and improving quality, relevance, equity, and access to education. The turnaround strategy will require both financial and technical assistance from partners, and we look to UNESCO and many of our partners for that to happen. Following yesterday's adoption of the Framework for Action 2030, I want to pledge Botswana's commitment to its implementation by bringing and aligning our ETSSP strategy to that framework. This alignment, Mr. President, will require that we map the various aspects of our strategy to make sure that it is implemented across all sectors. The government of the Republic of Botswana appreciates both the technical and financial support to the value of $15,000 it received from UNESCO with the support of the National Consultations on Education for Sustainable Development, the National Education for All Review, and the launch of the 2015 Global Monitoring Report. In addition, Botswana received $2 million over 5 years from UNESCO in collaboration with the Republic of South Korea through the BEAR project, whose goal is to address the mismatch between skills training and the needs of the labor market. Mr. President, I am pleased to confirm that the Southern and Eastern African Consortium for Monitoring and Education, SACMEC, Coordinating Center, has been relocated from Paris to Botswana. And we will host the 10th session of SACMEC later this month, that's the 26th and 27th of November, in Gaborone. And I look forward to hosting my fellow ministers in Gaborone. On a related matter, Botswana is still committed to the establishment of a Category 2 Institute for Skills Development, and we look forward to UNESCO's support as we work towards concluding this particular aspect. On social and human sciences, Mr. President, Botswana is a state party to the UNESCO International Convention Against Doping in Sport. And in this regard, we have received financial support worth $14,000 from UNESCO to implement the Clean Sport Project. This project aims to educate young athletes on key anti-doping issues. To this effect, Mr. President, a good number of sport teachers and student athletes have been reached. This has greatly assisted us to raise awareness on the hazards of doping and the importance of clean competitiveness in sport. On culture, Mr. President, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is our conviction that government, it is the conviction of the government of Botswana that the culture of people is central to the country's development. Hence, preservation of culture and habitat is one of the key national priorities. The founding president of our country has been credited as having said, a nation without a past is a lost nation, and a people without a past is a people without a soul. In this regard, Mr. President, we are actively pursuing the implementation of the UNESCO Convention on Cultural and Heritage, which has led to the listing of the Okavango Delta as the 1,000th World Heritage Site. And I pause to invite all of you, ladies and gentlemen, to come to Botswana and behold that particular wonder of nature. Lastly, ladies and gentlemen, to deepen our relationship with UNESCO, we offer to you a candidate for the executive board. And we believe that with your blessing, that will strengthen and deepen the relationship of Botswana to this august body. I thank you, Mr. President. Thank you.